Hey, how's everyone doing? So, this is episode 13 of our Daggerfall playthrough. So, last episode, we got a quest from Queen Minisera to talk to the leader of the orcs in Orsinium. So, we're going to do that today. We have a letter to deliver to him. So, yeah, let's go. Okay, and before we go there, I'm going to go to the Mages Guild and buy a spell. We need a reflect magic spell. Oh, we got demoted. Yeah, I haven't been doing many quests for them. So there's like a reputation system and we can get demoted. That sucks. But maybe in a future episode we'll do like mini quests and get promoted again. Orsinium's here. Let's see where the... It's So it's like the city of Orsinium in the state of Orsinium. So this is like the capital city of Orsinium, where orcs live. The orcs are trying to make it into their own country, but because of discrimination, they're not having problems with that. But King Lysandus was accepting of their cause, but he died. Anyway, let's go talk to the builder. So, Minisera seeks to sweet talk me. Bah! Her letter is of no value to me anymore. She may have it. However, my people may not be so lenient towards a high elf wandering the halls of Orsinium. If you can survive my realm and find the letter, you may take it back to her. I will also consider you to be a worthy high elf. Okay, so we have to go into the dungeon and find the letter. these things are really dangerous. He silenced me and I just ran and hid myself, waiting for the silence to go away.
Thank you.
Yeah, I think that's the letter. So this is the... Is this the letter that the Emperor sent us to find? Let me see. Yeah, it's this one. Okay, let me get to the exit and then we'll save and then try to read it. Okay, let's save. Queen Minisiera, I have grave news. The totem of Tiber Septim has been found. You know what this means. The power behind Tiber Septim could be unleashed upon Tamriel again. Rumor has it that Lord Woodborn, a minor lord of Weyrest, has possession of it. He will doubtless lose it soon. You must persuade him to turn it over to you or Lady Brissiana. The court of Weyrest has no love of King Lysandus, but you still have influence here. I'm asking you to use it on my behalf. Okay, reload and then let's get back to Queen Minisiera. Arsenium looks really nice. That hill looks beautiful. Even with the 2D trees, it kind of looks like a painting. Okay, so let's get back to Queen Minisiera. Okay, and we leveled up. So yeah, I have to increase agility now. Agility will let us dodge attacks. The nimbleness spell, it increases agility. It helps us against melee. But with high agility, even without the spell, it's going to help us. Thank you. it's back to being spring or summer. I like it better than when it snows. Yeah, see, so these sceneries look so much better when it's not snowing. Okay, let's give this letter. Gorlas, this letter is dangerous. Gortwog had undoubtedly sold copies of it to everyone from Wayrest to the Underking. After all, if the powers of the Iliac Bay become embroiled in war over a totem, he stands to gain quite a lot. Go now, you have done your job. I'm sure the totem will find its way into your life somehow. You seem to have a knack for such things. Just remember, the only safe master of the totem is the Emperor. Okay. So, we have finally solved the mystery behind the letter. We got two quests. One was to investigate who killed Lysandus. Who killed Lysandus? Why his ghost is haunting the city of Daggerfall? And the second was to find why the letter that the Emperor sent to Minas Tirith went missing. And we solved the letter problem. The letter reached the wrong queen. The letter had information about the totem of Tiber Septim. So that's a really powerful magical artifact, and since the kingdoms of High Rock and Hammerfell are squabbling amongst each other, they all want this totem and they're all going to fight over it, and Mani Marco and the Underking are also involved. So Tiber Septim is like the original founder of the empire. Well, not the original founder, but yeah, he was the conqueror of all of Tamriel, and yeah, he's the founder of the Septim dynasty. So the current emperor's ancestor. He was a powerful warlord and a dragonborn. So yeah, I guess next we have to find the totem, I guess. Now, in a much earlier episode, we did a quest for Prince Lothan in Sentinel, and he told us that the woman that King Lysandus was having an affair with, her name is Medora Dureni, and she's a high elf from the clan Dureni. And after the king died, Minis Tierra banished her and put a curse on her. So maybe we should go to her and talk to her and see what she has to say. Oh, and we got a message. Let's see what it is. Corellas, if you don't want to be dead as Lysandus, stop your investigations immediately. Do you really want to risk your life for a dead man? You are being watched. Oh. So whoever killed Lysandus is now trying to stop us from investigating further. Interesting, but we're not afraid. We're pretty powerful now, and now we've dealt with so much. Anyway, yeah, let's go and find Medora the Reni. Reaching into your pack for something to eat, you spy a note. It wasn't there before. Oh, we got another letter. Dear Corellas, Nomidium was Tiber Septim's secret weapon in his bid for supreme power. A 1,000-foot-tall automaton, a golem or an atronach of sorts, powered by a gem called the Mantella. The Mantella was infused with the life force of Tiber Septim's imperial battle mage, and with it, Septim crushed all who stood in his way. After the complete and total defeat of all his opponents, Septim began using Nomidium to crush the neutral royal families of Tamriel so that he could enthrone only persons he knew to be loyal. His imperial battle mage was furious at this use of his creation and fought to reclaim the Mantella. In the ensuing battle, both the created and creator were vanquished. The heart they shared blew out of this reality into the netherworld. They called Aetherius. The medium's body was scattered throughout Tamriel, and the imperial battle mage, without his life force, went into a semi-slumber in a subterranean vault. In the centuries that followed, the Emperor's elite soldiers for generation after generation collected the prices of the Nomidium, pieces of the Nomidium, and became known as the Blades. Tiber Septim's Imperial Battle Mage became known as the Underking and sent his forces out to find the Mantella. He warned, therefore, those who search for the totem of Tiber Septim are searching for the mechanism the first emperor of Tamriel used to control Nomidium. Should Nomidium return, he or she who holds the totem will control Tamriel's fate. I'm guessing friend is the Blades. Lady Brissiana, I think. Yeah. So, the Underking is the Imperial Battle Mage who worked for Tiber Septim. And he and Tiber Septim had a falling out because Tiber also attacked the neutral kingdoms who weren't enemies of his empire. But in the battle, the Nomidium, which is like a giant robot, yeah, it's like a magically powered robot. And yeah, he and that robot got banished. and the totem of Tiber Septim could control this robot again, and the Emperor can use it to conquer Tamriel again, because now some kingdoms are starting to rebel so many years after Tiber Septim died. So Tiber Septim's descendant, the current Emperor, the guy in the intro of the game that sent us in this quest in the first place, yeah, he wants it to reconquer and, you know, stop the opposition to his empire. And the other kings would also want it for their own gain. And Mani Marco would want it, and the Under King would want it, because, yeah, his soul is linked to it and he probably wants to be freed. Okay, interesting. So anyway, let's go and talk to Mithora. So Mithora is in the Isle of Belfiera, and she's like cursed to be trapped in a castle here. I'm guessing it's this, the Direni Tower, since her last name is Direni. Yep, let's go here. Someone's attacking us. Kill Korlas Hythar before too much is learned. Use any means. W. Okay, they're trying to stop me from investigating more. But it'll take more than that. He was pretty tanky though, but yeah, we easily outmaneuvered him. This is the tower. Thank you.
Thank you.
another assassin. So the assassins are following me into dungeons too. She was able to take care of the vampire though, so she's a pretty good assassin. Maybe they're hiring the Dark Brotherhood to come after me.
Thank you.
This is Midora Direni. We found her. Let's talk to her and see what she has to say. Greetings, Korlas. I am Midora Direni, former sorceress to the court of Daggerfall. I have an interest in helping you in your aim to exorcise the spirit of King Lysandus. But I can do little in my present circumstances. If you would pay a visit to a certain other sorceress, I can lift the curse on Direni Tower. Will you do this for me, Korlas?
Yes.
I will be in your debt, Korlas. Nulfaga, the mother of my former Lord Lysandus, is a renowned mystic. But I have heard whispers that the loss of her son has turned her mad with grief. If this is not true, she can and will help me. I need a certain rare item, the horn of a great unicorn, to break the curse on Direni Tower. If Nulfaga is indeed mad, you must search her castle for this horn yourself and bring it back to me. I will expect you back in 61 days. Okay, so we have a new quest now. I'm going to cast a recall anchor, because getting to her was like really time consuming. And anyway, I'm going to do that quest next episode. I'm ending this episode here today. Thank you for watching, and if you like this video, give it a like and subscribe if you want to be notified about more videos easily, and also the bell icon helps with that as well. And thank you for watching, and I'll see you on the next video.